Carahueca despertó porque alguien había dicho su nombre. Después de muchos, muchos años, era libre. Cuando Carahueca salió de su guarida, la gente le miraba sin verle. Era como si fuera invisible. Vio gente en la calle, charlando y besándose. Y supo que sin una cara, nadie le amaría.
Fresnadillo approach was so new, so original, that he was pushing the limits for what we were thinking about. I mean, he was bringing not only atmosphere and visuals, but also the fact that he wanted to drive the main character and to create some kind of journey from childhood to maturity. I think he had, Juan Carlos was adding something we love in the genre film, which is the motion. A movie driven by emotions, by scares, obviously, by something haunting, something that when you leave the theater, you keep with you.
Mia, ¿qué te pasa?
I think for Juan Carlos, it's not about, you know, who, when you hit your mark at the right time and, you know, whether the light hits you at the right time. I mean, that's a big part of it as well, and that is important. But it's more for him, you know, facial expressions and actually feeling the emotion and showing it, you know, through the ways that make you a better actress. So he says, for me, it's through my eyes. He says, you show all your emotion through your eyes. But for Clive and Chris, it would be different things that they do. On set, they're really good parents, and we have a laugh, and, you know, in the scene, they're both incredible actors, so it's really just easy to just feel connected to them because, you know, they're lovely people as well. But, I mean, they've also been really good parents off set as well because me and Chris are quite regular visitors to Twitter, so we go on that quite a lot. And we go out to dinner, and we just have a laugh and mess around.
Clive came very, very soon. Came very, very soon because we were trying to find some kind of peculiar element on the protagonist who was the hero. I mean, the Hitchcockian hero, you know, this guy who's able to support everybody, to fight for his own ideas, but we wanted to destroy this guy, that this man feel fragile in the end. He also had this kind of we wanted to put this character in jeopardy, in different and difficult situations from him. Pilar López Ayala is an incredible actress. Daniel Brühl is also fantastic. We saw him in Inglourious Basterds. Pilar is less known from the Anglo-Saxons, but she's going to be a revelation for them. The two kids were very, very difficult to find. And Carice Van Houten is an amazing actress. I mean, we felt that she was delivering some kind of realistic vision of the mother in this house.
The things I usually play are more disturbed, or people with a lot of problems, or have diseases, or mental diseases. And this actually is a woman that doesn't really have so many problems until the intruder comes in.
¿Qué pasa?
Está aquí. Está dentro.